And welcome in, everybody. Glad you're with us. Interleague Baseball on MLB The Show. It's the Los Angeles Angels taking on the Miami Marlins. First pitch coming your way next. Just about ready to roll here. Getting the nod in this one, Edward Cabrera.
Yeah, ZRA last year was a little worse than average, so definitely be looking for better results this season. One of the keys is just being able to have a consistent delivery and to be able to repeat that delivery so you can hit the spots that you want to hit and have a higher chance of being successful.
So in now for the Angels, Nolan Schanuel. And a pitch. Pump off the middle. That's a base hit. So a runner aboard to start the inning.
Well, that started and ended pretty quickly. No messing around right there. Timing on the swing was good. Able to shoot the ball up the middle. Didn't square it up as much as he probably would have liked, but that's a good approach paying off.
Anthony Rendon making his way to the plate. Two hits for him in yesterday's game. Up and in, and that's ball one.
Count 1-0.
Righty delivers. Swing and a foul back. That's out of play. Runner at first with no outs here. Swing and a miss as he was late.
One ball, two strikes.
Right-hander kicks, deals. Fly ball down the line. He's got it. One away. All right, let's take a look at the Angels lineup. And a big part of it, a guy with a great track record, Mike Trout.
Boog, it's kind of a joke that this guy's got a career OPS over 900. I mean, there are a lot of players that hope that they could just do that in one season, but he's done it his entire career. And in reality, there's only about 60 players that can claim that type of production.
Trout is one of the best players of his generation. He's a fan favorite because he brings a rare combination of speed, power, and all-around talent to the team. He's exactly the type of player you want to build around.
Got to be real careful here. 2-0. He's hunting for his pitch.
2-0. Fouled off. He was late.
He's mixing his pitches really well. Late on that fastball after seeing the changeup. See if he can elevate one. I think if he does, he'll get the swing and miss.
Schanuel leads off first with one away. Two, two on the way. Keeps the at-bat going with a foul ball. Righty to the plate.
Helpful.
Foul ball, and it remains a full count. And a swing and a miss. He didn't make it easy for him on the mound, but they still get the strikeout.
It's a strikeout, but they'll be in good shape if they make their outs as difficult as that one. Those grinding ABs take a toll on pitchers. The game goes on.
And next will be the cleanup hitter, Taylor Ward. Right through there for a strike. Ward, 30 years old now, a former first-round pick back in 2015. And a foul ball. Two gone, but the go-ahead run is at first. And we're just getting started here in the top of the first. 0-2. Well struck right field. That's back there. Got all of that one. He'll touch them all. And they add a pair. It's 2-0.
Scary for a pitcher when a guy can take a fastball down the middle and hit it to the opposite field. No holes in a swing like that, and that time that ball was hit hard.
Two outs, nobody on, and now the right fielder Mickey Moniak, and that gets the inside corner for a strike.
He's given up a couple of runs, but the pitch count really not as high as you would think. Might be able to get through this one under 25 pitches.
Two down, nobody on. That clips the zone. No balls, two strikes.
No balls, two strikes.
Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Blew the express right by his bat for strike three. Two-run shot for the Angels this inning. It's now a 2-0 ball game. Here with my pal Ziggy, and towing the slab in this one, Patrick Sandoval.
Try to stay back for that power changeup. Speed differential between the fastball and the changeup is huge. Hitters, they have a hard time staying back.
We go to the bottom of the first, and now it's going to be Tim Anderson. He's sitting on 99 career homers. We'll see if this is the moment to notch number 100. Slider misses outside.
Well, after putting up a nice inning on offense, got some runs across, this is where you look for the starter to go out there, have a shutdown inning. Don't give that other team any hope. You just hope they can get through this inning, get the bats back up there while they're hot.
That smash towards center. Dives, but it's off his glove. Base hit. Just kind of sliced that one into center.
You'll often hear the phrase short to it, long through it, and that's a great example of it right there. Got the barrel in the hitting zone early, squared it up with the well-timed swing, and came away with a beautiful line drive into center field.
Boots it. And no shot to get him at first. There's two aboard.
That is good. The second baseman,
Luis Arraez stands in. Misses the zone, and he gets him to chase.
All ones to count.
The Angels leading by two here in game one of this three-game set. Called strike right there.
All one, two.
And two now, and a foul ball. He stays alive. Left-hand batter waits.
One ball
in the dirt, but no advance from the runners. Anderson at second, Rivera at first with no outs. Laser base hit. Anderson flying around third. He scores. It's 2-1.
Well, there you go. The RBI machine. Another clutch run scoring at bat.
Yeah, he's been so good in these situations. Call it clutch if you want, but his resume speaks for itself. Jake Berger will hit next. Strike one.
It's great to get on the board in the first frame of the ball game, but here's an opportunity for them to really open things up with a couple of runners on. Let's see if they can cash in.
The 0-1. And a swing and a line drive into right field. That's a base hit. The throw home. Not in time. He saved it to play. It's 2-2.
Gets it done to drive in the run and tie it back up. Showed a willingness to drive that
pitch the opposite way. Didn't get jumped in, didn't try to pull the ball. He let it get deep, took the barrel right to it, and then extended through the swing for the line drive base hit.
First and second, no outs. Brian De La Cruz now at the plate. That's in there. That's strike one. And a curve misses outside.
Just missed with that backdoor breaking ball. If he gets a swing and miss or called strike, 0-2 count. Instead, it's 1-1. Look for him to go back to that pitch later in this at bat.
Ground ball right side, could be two. Goes to second for one. How about that double play? For me, that's one of the toughest double plays to turn on the infield. The first baseman has to get inside, create a throwing lane to hit that middle infielder to start the double play, and then from there, completing it back to first. Really good job all the way around.
Josh Bell at the plate now.
Good power, not great in the OBP department. Late on that fastball.
0-1's the count.
And a pitch.
Yep, that ball went out.
Check swing. Did he go? Yes, he did.
One ball, two strikes.
Tied up here in the early going. Two outs. Line drive, base hit. Runner from third comes across. It's 3-2.
Mission accomplished there as he picks up the RBI to give him the lead. He clearly didn't catch that one on the big part of the bat, just kind of muscled it out there. And on the mound, it can be pretty frustrating for a pitcher, but you just kind of have to expect those to drop in there sometimes.
And now the catcher comes up to him, Nick Fortes. And a good eye there. Stops the lead runner at second. Two on and two out.
Well, that'll make you feel good as a hitter right there.
That's about as textbook as it gets. Got his stride load out of the way early. He stayed inside that ball and squared it up out front. Man, that was like he was in the cage hitting off a tee.
Jazz Chisholm Jr. stands in now and watches strike one. One's in there. 0-2.
And a bat like this is almost over as it begins. In this situation, you have no idea what the next pitch is going to be. You just got to hope that you can make contact.
Line drive, base hit. Headed for the plate. Now a long throw home, but it's offline.
Really stayed true on that swing. It wasn't an easy pitch. Lefty on lefty. Pitch was a little down, a little bit away, but he committed to it. And his shoulder stayed square to the plate. Didn't try to pull off that ball at all. And that's why it jumped off the bat.
Abisail Garcia up to the plate. One of the stars in the win yesterday as he had three hits. And there's the strike.
Well, a really rough inning out there on the mound. And this is one of those where you learn a lot about a guy's toughness and his ability to turn the page and keep pressing forward.
That one fouled off. First and second, two down. Next offering is down low. Two on, two outs. Hard grounder into the outfield for a nine. Rounds third, headed for the plate. And he's out. Cut down, and that ends the inning.
Well, it's pretty difficult to throw a base runner out at the plate with two outs and a base hit to the outfield, but an excellent job of coming up with it, getting rid of it quickly, and throwing on the money. That is great technique from start to finish. Nice job to end the inning.
Here at Lone Depot Park. Second inning, set to go. Here's the Angels catcher, Logan Ohapi.
He gave up a couple of runs in the first. His offense picked him up. It's time for him to settle in now and throw up some zeros on that scoreboard.
Cabrera back to work. 1-0. Way outside, ball one. That one missed.
He hasn't wanted the challenge of both of those pitches off the plate away. Don't expect anything down the heart of the plate. You may just have to be patient and take your walk here.
Next offering is in for a strike.
Two balls, one strike.
The pitch. Here's the high heat past him. That's a strikeout. Brandon Drury to the plate. First pitch, and that's in for a strike. The fish up by two here at the top of the second. Got the bat going too soon. It's strike two. And Drummond, our umpire behind the plate in this one.
Yeah, Boog, he's a really fair umpire, both the pitchers and the hitters. So standard strike zone, he's consistent with it. And the great thing is you don't see players questioning the calls too much. So that's a good thing in this day and age.
Got him swinging. Back-to-back strikeouts to start the frame, and that's now three in a row.
Yeah, he's really settling in and getting a feel for his pitches, throwing them where he wants to right now. So we'll see how long he can keep this streak going.
Joe Adele in the box now. No balls and a strike. Two down, nobody on. Swings through that one for strike two.
The strong second inning is a confidence builder for him, a relief for his manager. Doesn't have to get into that bullpen quite as early.
Gonna count one and two.
One ball, two.
Two outs, base is empty. Wouldn't chase that time.
Great job of laying off those pitches down in the zone to even the count up at two and two. Such a better feeling for the hitter.
Now all even up. Now this is in the air down the line. And no one could get to it. It's a foul ball. Knocks that one away, and we'll do it again. Breaking ball, and that got him. He had two strikes on him, and he hit him. Runner at first with two away. Luis Renjifo gets a chance to hit here. Just off the outside edge. And the 1-0. Just missed. Chris, with that distraction and the speedy guy at first, he's in a favorable hitter's count.
Well, if nothing else, I mean, this is a great spot for a hitter to be in.
Two outs. And it is 2-1.
Filthy changeup right there. Just pulled the string.
The pitch. Foul ball, another 2-2 upcoming. Throw to first. Adele back in standing.
Base runner with a one-way lead right there. All he's trying to do is get a look at the pitcher's move. Had no intent of stealing on that pitch.
The 2-2 chases the changeup in the dirt. In time. So the drop third strike doesn't hurt him, and that's that. Angels lead one. They trail it here 4-2. And we're back. Bottom of the second. Here's Tim Anderson.
Possibly thinking about home run number 100 here. He's just one shy of that milestone.
The wind of the pitch. That's in there. That's strike one.
It's a good changeup to hit up in the zone. I don't think he recognized it. I'm sure he'd love to have that one back.
The other way. And that's a fair ball. Takes the turn. He's digging for second. The throw to second is offline.
Wasting no time. He's two for two now on the night. And just a triple and home run away from the cycle.
Seriously, we're starting with this already. So, man aboard. Now, Emmanuel Rivera. And a foul ball. Two now as he swings through it.
No ball, two strikes.
Next offering misses down and away.
Well, the good thing so far is that he hasn't issued any free passes. Unfortunately, they're making pretty good contact, so not getting the swings and misses and making that defense work behind him.
Next pitch is outside. And that one almost got him.
He should get a pretty good pitch to hit here with three-hole hitter coming up if he's walked.
Runner in scoring position, nobody out. Bottom half of inning number two. That's out to center field. And a base hit. Anderson around third. Fires it to the plate. He's safe.
Well done. Drives in the run. Didn't try to do too much with it. Just a really controlled, simple swing. We don't see a whole lot of that these days with hitters trying to launch and hit home runs, but sometimes you got to shorten up just like that.
And now for the Marlins, Luis Arraez. Singled and drove in a run his first time through. Gets him to chase after that one.
All ones that count.
One on, nobody out, a run in here in game one of this three-game set. Next offering is in for a strike.
Two really good back-to-back sliders, now in an 0-2 count. He's feeling real confident about finishing this hitter off. He can go anywhere he wants.
And that one is inside. And a ball and two strikes. Swings through it, and that's a strikeout.
Well, that slider was way out of the zone, and for me, it just comes down to not seeing the pitch out of the hand, not tracking it into the zone, and then also being a little bit anxious, not confident in your two-strike approach. And so when a guy's in that position, you get him to commit early, and a lot of times you get the swing and miss, as you did right there.
Here's the cleanup hitter for Miami, Jake Berger. That one's in there, 0-1. And a pitch. Not ball, even close strike. There. And the count is 1-1. Popped up. Shanuel calls it in, 2 away.
The bat has no left fielder.
And at first, Brian De La Cruz, the next up for the Marlins. 0-1 so far.
This kid picked up in a trade. A lot was offered and given to get him, but He's got a real high ceiling. That one in there across the letters.
Well, he had a pretty good look at that pitch and not sure exactly what tied him up there. Couldn't pull the trigger. And perhaps the best pitch he'll see in this at bat to hit.
0-2 now. Into center. Trout is there. And that is that. So one run in the inning on this base hit. It's 5-2. You're dialed into the show. And welcome back to the ballpark. And here's the first baseman, Nolan Schanuel. And the right-hander back to work. Pulled hard, but it's a foul ball. And that one is lifted in the air. And that gets down into the gap. Around first and hustling for second. In safely. It's a double and his second hit.
A couple of hits in a row for him here. This is why hitters work so hard on driving the ball gap to gap in batting practice. There's a lot of room out there. If you can rip one into that open space, it usually means extra bases.
Here's Anthony Rendon up to the plate. He's 0 for 1. First offering misses badly for ball one.
You know, these Angels showing great discipline at the plate, and patience definitely seems to be the name of their game in this one. They're doing a good job of working the pitch count, and they've been able to push a couple of runs across to score as well.
Swing and a miss. Ugly swing right there.
Still relatively early, but with a pair of runs already on the board, the ripple effect of that high pitch count might set them up to do more damage later in this game.
And the righty deals. Up and in. The count now 2-2. Right through there. Got him. Not what you're looking for after the leadoff double. A strikeout. And there's one away.
No, just couldn't pull the trigger on the fastball right there, and I don't think he was taking it, thinking it might be a called ball or anything. I just think he was flat out frozen. Did not expect that location, in my opinion.
Trout takes a ball as he stands in for the second time. Go crisp in the early stages. He hasn't been very efficient in terms of the pitch count. He's going to need to get some quick outs if he's going to get deeper into this game. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. It is interesting, though, when you consider the way the game is run now, doesn't even matter that much if your starter doesn't go that deep because teams are really aggressively building their bullpens. Man at second.
Two balls, two strikes.
Slider misses outside. Schanuel leads off second with one gone in the inning. Spoils the two-strike pitch, and he'll see another. Three, two. Gets a piece there. We'll do it again.
Well, he's having a tough time getting a pitch by him. As a hitter, you feel pretty confident that you're seeing different pitches still able to make some type of contact.
Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Now a chance for Taylor Ward. He's already homered here in this one. First pitch just misses. And another ball
Well, usually a high level of confidence when you're facing a young pitcher out there on the mound. In this situation, ahead 2-0, he's put himself in a really good spot.
2-0 to Cal. Here it comes. Hey.
In there at the knees. In today's game, not that many fastball counts, but hitters still in the back of their minds, they're looking for one. 2-0 changeup call right there. Excellent pitch selection to go with.
2-1 now. Right through there for a strike. The Marlins leading by three. We're here in the top half of inning number three. On the ground to first, Bell. He takes it himself to the bag, and that'll do it. Angels strand one. They trail at 5-2. Set for the bottom of the third. And now the switch hitting first baseman, Josh Bell. As he turns on the rubber, here with that good live arm delivers. Base hit. Man aboard on the leadoff single.
Tough game for him so far, but another hit, and they've just been knocking him around through the first two plus. He's got to get things back on track. Maybe junk a pitch that isn't working, or he might not last much longer.
Nick Fortes, the next up for the Marlins. And he's already singled in this game. Out towards right center field. Touches down. That's a hit. And now runners at the corners. Nobody out.
Went up there looking to be aggressive and got something he could handle. Put a pretty good jolt into that one. Great swing, nice balance, and great transfer. And he got it to drop in out there in the deep part of the field.
Jazz Chisholm Jr. now. 1-for-1 with a single so far. And immediately pumps in a strike to the left-handed hitter.
You know, these Marlins putting together some really good at-bats in this game. There's been a lot to like with how they're approaching their chances at the plate. Looking at the numbers, they've got four hits when they're behind in the count. That says they are absolutely battling at the plate. And
that one back up the middle, and it gets through. Runner in from third to extend their lead. It's 6-2.
Comes through with the RBI. Really nice job staying up the middle with his approach. He didn't try to do too much with the pitch. Just shot it through the infield.
And at the plate for Miami, Abisail Garcia. Out front and foul to the left side. And he'll one. And that's a strike. Fortes over at second. Chisholm on at first with nobody out. Swings and misses. Struck him out.
We'll take a look at the three-pitch sequence here. Pretty separate in terms of putting them away at the plate. Once you're ahead, 0-2 as a pitcher, you can really expand the zone and see how aggressive that hitter is going to be trying to protect the battle. And right there, clearly he was in swing mode, but all you can do is hope to foul that off.
So up next, Tim Anderson. First pitch, and he just misses. Two on, one out. Runners on the move. Fair ball. Coming home. One run across.
Picks himself up at RBI. Anytime you rip a line drive the other way, you feel really good about what you did at the plate. You trusted your hands, you let the ball travel, and you took the barrel straight to it. That's great work right there.
Manager out of the dugout now, and it looks like we'll see a change on the mound. Patrick Sandoval done for the night, and the line not closed on him yet as he's responsible for the runners on base. Back with a new pitch. Jose Suarez. comes on now.
And never an easy situation coming in with runners at second and third. He's got a base to work with, so he doesn't have to be perfect, but he does have to make some quality pitches.
And up next for Miami, Emmanuel Rivera. Rolled softly, but that goes foul.
Not the easiest thing when you're talking about a guy that's, you know, perhaps is going to be in the rotation, you know, maybe a long relief guy, to not start an inning, to come into an inning with pressure on it and try to get yourself comfortable.
At the belt and fires.
Inside, ball one.
Foul ball there. Here comes a pinch. Good job to fight that one off. And a ball evens the count. On the ground, right side, Drury gathers and throws to first. There for the out. Runner scores from third. And now for the Marlins, Luis Arraez. One for two. Getting an RBI base hit back to the first. Base hit. The run scores from third, and it's 9-2. And that's a two-out double.
Waste no time there. And, man, I'll tell you, a line drive like that into the gap just feels so good. It's feedback that you have everything on time and in control from start to finish with your swing.
So two down. Jake Berger, the next up for the Marlins. One for two. That one finds the zone, and that is strike one. Four runs already in the frame here in the last half of the third. Next pitch downstairs, and the count even 1-1. Man on second, two down. Pitch misses there. Ball two. And he grounds one to the right side. That's a hit. Around third. Here's the throw to the plate. It's off the mark, and he scores.
It's around the board and picks up an RBI. Not much to this one other than just a willingness to go the other way and put the ball in play. That's a team to bat right there. Nice job of staying back and letting the ball get deep.
Two outs, runner at first. And at the plate for Miami, Brian De La Cruz.
0-1's the count.
Berger off of first with two away. In there for a strike at the top of the zone.
He doesn't seem to like to pitch up. Hasn't offered on either one of those pitches. 0-2 count now. I think the guy's going to climb the ladder out there.
Fights that one away, and the count remains 0-2. Two outs. And a swing and a miss. And that's that. So five runs in the inning as they bat around. Three innings complete. It's the Marlins 10 and the Angels 2. Start of the fourth. Now it's the right fielder, Mickey Moniak.
Mickey. Clearly down in this ball game, and you can't look at the deficit and try to get it all back in one swing. It's got to come one at bat at a time, and even shrink it down smaller, pitch to pitch. Make that guy on the mound work to get you out.
kicks and deals.
Ball. 1-1.
On the ground, right side. Arise on to first. And one gone to the fourth as they get the leadoff man. Here's the catcher, Logan Ohapi. His first at bat was a strikeout. That one's in there. Going one.
Going one.
The fish up big in this one. Top half of inning number four. Just missed. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. Hammers that one deep left field and forget it. A gigantic blast. His first homer of the year, it's 10-3. That was blasted.
Absolutely, no doubt off the bat.
With this pitcher's velocity, a changeup is really a break for a hitter. He got a BP fastball, didn't move a whole lot, and he absolutely tattooed it.
Brandon Drury, the next to hit for the Angels. And that is in for a strike. It's 0-1. Ball one there. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. Stays alive. And down on strikes. And there's two down. Two outs, bases empty. Here's Joe Adell. He was plunked in his first trip to the plate.
Adell.
And that one clips the corner. Adell goes 6 feet 3 inches, 215 pounds, and he's usually in the outfield. Today he's the DH. Here's the 0-2. Hits and misses. It's a strikeout. But a solo home run will at least get this closer to respectability. And it is now 10-3. Major League Baseball is on the show.
Yeah, I'm a gone boy. Yeah, I left it all in the dust. I'm a gone boy. No way he ain't gonna turn to rust. I'm a gone
boy. Bottom four, here's Josh Bell.
The first base.
And he deals. He takes a strike.
0-1's the count.
In the air to left down the line. Makes the grab, one down.
Good pitch. He just kind of had him out in front on that pitch away and wasn't able to stay close.
Nick Fortes, the next up for the Marlins. Fastball in for a strike, and it's 0-1. A little out front there as he swings through it.
No ball, two strikes.
That's inside. 1-2 to count. One out, bases empty. Fights that one away. Still 1-2. The pitch. Swing and a miss. That one in the dirt. And there's two gone following the strikeout.
He's locked in at the plate when he's using the whole field. He was out in front there. Just needs to let the ball travel a little more, and his timing will be back on track. Good pitch for the strikeout.
And up next for Miami, Jazz Chisholm Jr. Sharp grounder. That's through for a base hit. So a two-out knock keeps the inning alive.
All over that one right there. Smash that one through the infield with a knock. When it's hit that hard, it makes it very tough on the infielders to make any sort of play.
Abisail Garcia digs in now. There's a strike. Step off, throw to first. Chisholm dives back in safely. And the pitch. That clips the corner.
Well, he's gotten ahead with two pitches down in the zone. He has plenty of options right here. He can go up, he can go away, he can add velocity, he can subtract.
That one just misses.
It's a good
one
take.
One ball, two strikes.
And another ball.
Two balls, two strikes.
The pitch. Spoils that one, and it remains 2-2. And that just misses.
3-2, two out, runner on first. A lot of movement in the infield. Hitter's got to stay focused on the pitch.
Swing and a foul ball at the plate. They'll do it again. Swing and a ball lined out towards center. And a base hit right there. And now they'll have runners on the corners with two away.
The batter number 7. Shortstop.
Back to the top of the lineup. Now it's the Marlins leadoff hitter, Tim Anderson. 3 for 3, doubled twice and singled. Not close with that one, and that's ball one. Lefty out of the stretch, runners at first and third. That one's in there, and the count 1-1. The 1-1 is fouled off. And now the lefty swings through that, and it's a strikeout. That's out number 3. Marlins strand a pair, but they still lead by 7. It's 10-3. Now piss your homie rolling. Let me offer my condolences. You don't know just how I'm doing. And the silence gold, I'm broke because they know I've been talking fluent. Got them under the influence. The truest is talking to them. But it's on your ego bumping them out. Music on it. Hey, back here in Miami, top 5, John Schaube with Chris Singleton. And leading it off, Luis Rengifo. Cabrera back to work. Outside corner, there's a strike. Miami's bullpen with some action. A.J. Puck, the left-hander, up and throwing. Rogers also throwing. Here comes the 0-1. Out to short. Slings it across. And the leadoff man set down in their half of the fifth.
Now batting the first baseman, Nolan Schanuel.
And next for the Angels, Nolan Schanuel. And the first pitch misses for ball one. And that one just missed off the outside edge. The Marlins up big in this one. And we're at the top of the fifth. Fought off foul. The wind of the pitch. Good eye in that spot.
And that's awfully close. I don't know how you take that. He's seeing the ball out of the pitcher's hand really well right now.
Foul. We'll see another payoff pitch. Righty delivers. Swing and a miss, and he got him. He battled for a long time, but it finishes with a strikeout. You can't be mad at yourself after an at bat like that one. Now it's Anthony Rendon. And first offering is fouled off. The Halos with a lot of ground to make up here in game one of this three-game set. Next pitch in the dirt. 1-1. Breaks his bat, pops it up. Bell makes the play, and that'll do it. Angels held in check. Not what they were looking for. It's 10-3. I keep coming back. Bottom of the inning. And now for the Marlins, Emmanuel Rivera. And a breaking ball drops in for a strike.
You know, these Marlins really impressing me with the quality of their at-bats in this one. It's been fun getting a chance to see them go to work. It looked to me like they really wanted to get to the starter early, get him out of the game before he settles in. So I'd say mission accomplished.
And another ball.
Two balls, one strike.
Headed down the line. Nobody can get there, and it's a foul ball. In the air, center field. Trout settles under it and makes the grab. One down.
The batter, number three, second baseman, Luis.
And at the plate for Miami, Luis Arraez. Chris, baseball today, so many strikeouts, and they are available to pitchers. But this is a guy that puts the bat on the ball and is kind of different from the players that we see day in, day out. That one pushed to the left and foul.
Yeah, his swing is so good. It's in the zone a long time. He gets the barrel to it a lot, and that produces more base hits.
Hacks and misses. It's a strikeout.
Came inside with that two-strike fastball nicely and just bunched him up on the inside part of the plate. Couldn't get around on it and catch it out front. Many times if you do, it's a foul ball. And you know, a lot of pitchers, they really don't like working inside with two strikes because they do not want to hit that batter. And when they've got him up against the ropes, got to figure out a way to put him away. Did a nice job right there.
Berger in the box with two gone and takes a look at a called strike. Lifted to left center, way back there, and that is gone. A massive home run, and they boost their lead. It's 11-3.
Times the pitcher's asking for a new baseball. Just like that.
Now the left fielder, Brian De La Cruz. That one clips the outside corner. That's strike one. two down, nobody on. And that one fouled off. And he'll two.
Ball.
Two down, base is empty, but one run across. Last half of inning number five. Breaking ball inside. It's two and two. Swing and a line drive, base hit out of the center field, and that keeps the inning alive.
That could be a dangerous pitch if you don't get it inside enough, because as a hitter, you see it coming across the plate the whole way. No problem handling it and putting a good swing on it that time.
In the air, left side. Ward drifts towards it. Pulls it down, and he makes the catch. And that ends the inning. One for the Marlins on the solo shot. Five innings complete. You're watching Major League Baseball exclusively on the show. Back, and they make a change to start the sixth. The new pitcher, AJ Puck.
And you know, bullpen guys can struggle sometimes when they're called upon with big leads, because it just doesn't have the same intensity as a tight game. So we'll see how sharp he is. Your mental toughness matters in situations like this as well.
Here's Mike Trout, who's 0 for 2 with a pair of strikeouts. And the pitch. And there's a ball.
Ball one, no strike.
The pitch. Swing and a foul over the screen and back out of play. One, one down. That one is absolutely belted. De La Cruz going back on this one. Leaping.
Well, he just took that away from one of the best in the league. It's not going to happen very often, but when you get the opportunity, better make the play, and he did right there.
Here's the left fielder, Taylor Ward. He's already homered in this game. Swings through that one. 0-1.
0-1's the count.
And here it comes. That one not close. And now it's even 1-1. Wouldn't chase that time.
We got two balls, one strike.
In the air, right field. Makes the grab, two down.
The right fielder, number 16.
Next to hit, Mickey Moniak. Ripped to short. Anderson to first. And that's the third out. Nothing doing for the offense that time. 7-8-9 due up in the home half of the inning. It's the Marlins 11 and the Angels 3. Back here at Lone Depot Park. And here's the catcher, Nick Fortes. And a pitch. And that one clips the corner. And that misses off the outside edge. Kicks and fires. This one high in the air to left center. Ward drifts towards it. Makes the catch, and there's one gone.
The center fielder, number two.
And up next for Miami, Jazz Chisholm Jr. 3-for-3 with three singles. Gets the outside corner with that one. It in on the warning track.
Up next, Marlins.
Amasayu Garcia, the next to hit. This one lifted in the air, left field. Ward makes the catch, inning over. We're back. We go to the top of the seventh. So in now for the Angels, Logan Ohapi. The pitch. And that's in for a strike. Signs of activity in the pen for the Marlins. Number 34, the veteran right-hander, appears to be loosening up. Nardi also getting ready. And ball one. Check swing. Now a look down to first. Nope, he held back. Down swinging for the strikeout. Couldn't hit the fastball at the knees.
Up next for the
and next for LA, Brandon Drury.
Brandon Drury.
In his fourth year, 28 years old, and they went out and made a trade for him last season. That misses one the and zone. 1-0. And a strike on the outside edge. So a foul ball makes it 1-2. One down, base is empty. Battling here as he fouls it away. One, two now. And whoa, another ball. Big foot slider ties him up, struck him out. Joe Adell, the next to hit for the Angels.
Joe Adell.
Swing and a high fly ball down the left field line, but hooking foul. That one missed. The fish up big in this one here in the top half of inning number 7. Angels retired 1-2-3. Angels go quietly there, still 11-3. And welcome back to the ballpark. And the batter will be the shortstop, Tim Anderson. line and the pitch. And first offering is fouled off. Anderson swings through that. Meanwhile, activity in the bullpen. Jimmy Herget preparing to come on if needed. Cisnero getting cranked up as well. Oh, that got away from him. And he's going to reach on a hit by pitch to lead off the inning.
Well, in the box, he's seen that movie before. It wasn't a good movie either. He knew how it was going to end right from the beginning.
And a foul ball. And the lefty with the 0-1. Hit on the ground, might be two. Slings to second. Relay to first. Double play.
As a former player, watching 5-4-3 double plays brings back some adrenaline. It's such an exciting play, and it's always a great reminder of baseball being such a team sport.
Two outs, bases empty. Luis Arraez, the next up for the Marlins. And first offering is fouled off. And a foul ball.
Well, two outs and a chance to put up a zero on the scoreboard here, and that's not something that's come easy for this staff in this one.
Next offering upstairs.
Well, he missed badly with that 0-2 fastball. Hitter has to understand, probably wants to try to put him away with that pitch, so got to stay ready for it.
Two outs. And delivers outside. And that's just foul. Two down, nobody on. Here at the bottom of the seventh. Two now. Swing and a high fly ball to left. Ward drifts towards it. Hauls it in to end the inning.
Sorry if I messed our hip hop material. Sorry if I'm sad. It'll take a miracle for my dreams to come true. Cause it's set too high. I'm in the clouds. If I fall off, I might just die. Let me rap like a.
We go to the eighth. So in now for the Angels, Luis Rengifo. Puck back to work. The shortstop takes a ball. Right through there for a strike.
In this situation, you expect the batters to be a little more patient, possibly take until they get a strike. With that, you don't want to miss your opportunity to get ahead early in the count. He didn't right there.
Here comes a pitch. And now 2-1. Wouldn't chase that time. That one ripped right center field back there. That one is gone. A solo shot. His first homer of the year. It's 11-4.
That fastball wasn't even in the zone, and he was still able to hit it out. Wow. That's the exact definition of hitting the ball where it's pitched, taking that outside fastball and driving it the opposite way out of the ballpark. You want to bottle that type of approach.
Nolan Schanuel, the next to hit for the Angels. Looked like it was a little bit up. Nobody. nobody on, nobody out with a run in, and we're in the top of the eighth. And now 2-0.
With the big bats coming up and a home run already surrendered, he's really going to have to execute against these next couple of batters.
And a pitch. That one's spoiled, and the count now 2-1. And misses inside. And he walked him.
Perfect. It's tough after falling behind a hitter, two balls and no strikes, but now at least he gets a fresh start against a new batter. But he needs to get back into the strike zone and start pitching with conviction.
Rendon in the box here, lets that one go for a ball.
Ball one, no strike.
The Angels with a lot of ground to make up here in game one of this three-game set. And that drops in for a strike.
Good approach right there. You want to get something just a little higher that you can elevate. Stay out of that double play.
Swing and a pop-up. Foul territory for the catcher. He makes the grab, and there's one away.
The center fielder, number 27, Mike Trout.
Man at first, and now batting Mike Trout. 0-for-3 with two strikeouts and a flyout. Foul back our way, and that's out of play.
Part of the order coming through now, and with one home run already in this inning, they're definitely looking to do some more damage.
0-1 down. And that one is inside. Man at first, one away. That one in there to Mike Trout.
One way to make a guy real uncomfortable at the plate is pound him inside with good velocity. They're doing that right here.
And that one hammered. Chisholm raging back towards the wall. He brought it back.
Now back left field, Taylor Ward.
So man aboard, Taylor Ward, the next to hit for the Angels. 1-for-3. First pitch misses. Right through there for a strike. Shadowell, the runner at first with two gone. Two outs. And it drops in. Throw in holds the lead runner at second. Two on now with two away. And now the right fielder, Mickey Moniak. Swings through that one for strike one.
0-1.
Is outside, ball one. Two outs, couple of base runners at first and second. And another ball. Next pitch is outside.
Really good take, especially with two strikes.
foul ball, and it remains a full count. Two on, two outs. Fouled off again, and it remains 3-2. Payoff pitch, and they'll do it again. Fly ball to right. Garcia makes the play, and it's out number three. Angels get one with a solo homer. Last half of the eighth coming up. It's Major League Baseball, and it's on the show. Back now, new pitcher on the mound as we roll into the bottom of the eighth, Jimmy Hergen. He's making his second appearance of the season. Now here's the cleanup hitter for Miami, Jake Berger.
With this kind of lead, he can swing freely, try to hit the ball out of the park, do what he loves to do.
So why to kick the pitch? Just off the outside edge, and it's 1-0. And that's downstairs and outside.
Back-to-back breaking pitches away, you get the feeling as a hitter that the pitcher's afraid of you, that he doesn't want to challenge you. So I think the confidence level is raised right here.
Breaking ball through there for a strike.
Nasty 2-0 slider there for a strike. That tells you he's got a lot of confidence in that pitch.
Righty to the plate. On the ground, right side. And that's one he's away out. As the leadoff man is out in the eighth.
Up next is Marlins. The left fielder. Royer.
Now the left fielder, Brian De La Cruz. First pitch doesn't find the zone. Activity in the bullpen for the Angels. Luis Garcia, the hard-throwing righty, is up and loosening. One down, base is empty. Gets under and pops it up. Rengifo under this one. Corrals it. Two down.
Now back. The first base.
So two down now, and here is Josh Bell. And a breaking ball drops in for a strike. And that's in there at the knees.
Well, he didn't like those first two pitches. Down an 0-2 hole. He's going to have to battle. Hope he gets a mistake.
Two down, nobody on.
One ball, two strikes.
Bounce it back with two strikes. Big foot slider struck him out. Nothing doing for the Marlins. They lead it, though, 11-4. We're back. It's the top of the ninth, and there's a new pitcher on the mound, number 34.
Compared to some days, this is a pretty low leverage appearance for him, so he should be fairly free and easy out there. Still have to keep yourself sharp and attack the strike zone.
Here's the Angels catcher, Logan Ohapi.
The catch has number 14. Ohapi.
The pitch. Off the plate inside, and that is ball one. And another ball. Fouls one off. 2-2. At the belt and fires. Close, but called a ball. Full count now. And down on strikes he goes. And a strikeout for the first out here in the ninth.
Well, he's going to have some thinking to do when he leaves the ballpark after this one. That was his third strikeout, and this one looking, obviously, so he's been a little overmatched. He's got to find a way just to be more competitive up there at the plate.
And first offering is fouled off. The Halos with a lot of ground to make up here at the top of the ninth. That ball one off the mark, and that's ball one. Action in the pen down there. JT Shagwa up and loosening in the pen. And the righty deals. Swing and a pop up. Foul at a play off to the right side. That'll find the stands. Cut on and miss, struck him out, and he's gone for the fourth time tonight.
Very strong coming out of the pen so far as he punches out the first two batters he's faced in this one, getting straight to work. Man, it's talked about a lot, but relievers are just so electric these days. These aren't fun at bats if you're a hitter. I'm so glad I'm retired.
Adele stands in now and watches strike one. The Angels down to their final strike. Just off the inside edge. Just misses with that one.
That turns out to be a really good take right there, but you don't want to end this game with the bat on your shoulder.
The 2-2.
Full count.
And that's too high. Ball four.
Thank you, Ben.
One of the things about that two-out walk, the base runner over at first base is going to have a very aggressive secondary lead. So ball down the line or into the gap will produce a two-out RBI, and those are the best. That is, if you are the offensive side of it.
Rengifo in the box now. No balls and a strike.
One.
Most hitters are looking for a first pitch fastball. You're not really timed up for a changeup. So if it's well located by the pitcher.
That one pushed foul out of play off to the left. Two outs. Fouls that off to the left and we'll do it again. The 0-2. Trying to get him to chase on the changeup that time. Right-hander kicks, deals, fouls it off, still 1-2. And he deals. Foul ball, still a 1-2 count. Right-handed reliever. And a swing and a miss, and that is the ball game.
Seven runs. It's a really encouraging game all the way around. The hitters feel good about what they did in this one, but the pitchers also know that if they get into a little bit of a jam, they know the offense is very capable of putting up runs. Good job.
Final score in this one, 11-4. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Chalmers. Thanks for joining us.
Sometimes I put wings on. Every hill in single Saturday night, just kicking it with my best man. Looked at my left hand, I got a ring on. How did we get here? Started with a kiss, then another kiss, then another kiss, then a covered dish with white rice, greens, and smothered fish. I'm lying, it was just chicken. Now we got a covenant, it's on the bond for life. In all my years, this was the easiest song to write. It's my confession in the